Hi, my name is Nina Matthiessen, and I am Developer Relations Manager here in Signicat. In this video, you will learn about the APIs available in Signicat Express. This video gives an overview of the different APIs and what you typically use them for. The next videos show you how to actually integrate to the different APIs. So you can use this video to figure out which APIs are for you, or you can go straight ahead to the relevant video tutorial if you already know which APIs you need to use. So we are going to discuss the following APIs: the Authentication API, the Identity Validation APIs, and the Signature API. And while we're explaining the different APIs we offer, we're also going to explain three very important terms: verification, authentication, and validation. Verification is about checking that something, in this case, identity, is actually true in the real world. Verification is not something you need to do very often, maybe just once per user. Once you have verified a user, you want an easy way to allow them to authenticate their identity as often as they like. Think logging in. Authentication is basically a person proving that they are who they say they are. Authentication may seem pretty similar to verification, and in a certain sense it is quite similar. We also use the same API to carry out both functions, but it can be useful to know that these are somewhat different terms. Validation, on the other hand, is about checking whether something matches an external registry. Sometimes we use validation to validate whether the information provided by the user matches the external registry, or we use validation to obtain additional information about a person or an organization from a reliable independent source. Think data enrichment. We're also going to explain this with an example, which uses cats. Later on, we'll cover this with more typical examples, but this is just to help explain these terms and how our APIs work in an easy way. So picture this: you're developing an app that allows cat owners to get in touch with cat sitters. You've noticed that cat owners are reluctant to hire a cat sitter if the cat sitter's identity is not verified. Presumably, they don't feel very safe placing their cat in the care of someone who could remain anonymous. What you need to do is ensure that the cat sitter is exactly who they claim to be by verifying their identity. Today, there are a handful of EIDs that make this process quick, easy, and secure, such as Norwegian Bank ID, Swedish Bank ID, or Dutch Eden, just to name a few. So when you ask a cat sitter to verify their identity through an EID, you can be sure that they are who they say they are, since these identities are provided by banks and other trustworthy institutions. You can also choose to verify the user through social login methods such as Google, Facebook, or GitHub. For this, you, in either case, use the Authentication API. Now that you have verified your cat sitter, you want to ensure that only the verified cat sitter can get access to their account. The relevant term here is authentication. Authentication involves recognizing an existing user when they want to log in. And if we think about it, this is something both cat owners and cat sitters would like, since the cat sitter doesn't want someone else to get access to their user and claim to be them. Again, we're using EIDs for authentication, which allows an easy, fast, and secure login experience. And you can choose to offer a different method for authentication, or you can use the same method as you provided for verification. For this, you also use the Authentication API. And as mentioned, we provide both verification and authentication through the Authentication API. And the reason for this is that the Authentication API is highly secure and therefore good enough for verification purposes, but also easy enough to offer frequent logins for authentication purposes. However, your customer may still want to know a little bit more about their cat sitter than their mere identity. There could be other information that they want to know. Maybe they want to know, for instance, the address of the person taking care of their cat. Here you're validating against an external address register and fetching this information automatically. Here you can either use the Information Services API if you only want to fetch this information once, but if you want to continuously keep this information updated, you use the Monitoring API. So let's go through these APIs one more time, and this time discuss them with more typical use cases. If you're looking for an API to allow your users to be verified and authenticate themselves to your platform in a secure manner, the Authentication API is what you're looking for. For instance, you may want to allow new users to sign themselves up in a quick and easy fashion. And once that's done, you may want to allow users to log into your platform whenever they want. For instance, customers may want access to a My page or a My profile to change a forgotten password, adjust their preferences, or other things. These all make use of the Authentication API. Let's move on to identity validation. So Signicat offers two APIs for identity validation, the Information Services API and the Monitoring API. Both APIs can be used to look up a single response to a query, to perform a search giving multiple responses, or to validate whether a single attribute belongs to a person. These APIs are also important for complying with AML, anti-money laundering laws, or KYC, know your customer requirements, or CDD, customer due diligence. So, what kind of information can you actually look up? Both APIs may be used to look up several kinds of information about a person, such as name, address, if they're a politically exposed person, their credit rating, and other things. It can also be used to look up information about an organization, such as roles, ownership, credit rating, and so on. Monitoring API is similar to Information Services API, but it allows you to perform continuous periodic checks instead of a one-time check. Again, this can be used for both validating people and organizations. Finally, with a signature API, you can obtain digital signatures from your customers, for example, if you need them to sign a contract. The great thing about the signature API is that it allows you to obtain binding signatures entirely online, eliminating the need for a face-to-face meeting. At the same time, you get the identity of the person who signs in, so it also acts as a kind of authentication API. The signature API can send a document across borders ready to be signed within a minute. It also allows for elaborate signing schemas where multiple signers can sign in a given order. Now that you learn about the different APIs we have to offer and what they can do, you may have an idea of which ones are right for you. The next video will explore how to actually connect to these APIs. And if you have any questions or comments or suggestions, you can just write them below or in the community page. And thanks for watching.